turtles are a common sight in Bloomington, and they have been long before the city was incorporated. Historically, when the Dakota fully managed this land, it was wide open spaces dotted with lakes, wetlands, and ponds. It was an ideal landscape for turtles. However, over the past 100 years, the city's changed very quickly to an urban environment, and the turtles have adapted fairly well. But this urban ecosystem has brought many challenges for these unique reptiles. Turtles will leave the safety of water for various reasons. In the spring, females may seek out safe spots to nest in the forests, yards, or nearby meadows. In the summer, they may forage for food or go to a new pond. And in the fall, before it gets too cold, they may return back to their favorite pond to settle down in the mud for a long winter. The most common area for turtles to move is the space between nearby water bodies. An example of this in Bloomington is along East Bush Lake Road. On both sides of the road are nearby wetlands, streams, and ponds that turtles are commonly moving between. All this movement makes it very difficult to prevent turtles from being hit by cars. So, what can we do? A direct intervention might look like building a protected wildlife crossing. For turtles, this could look something like a tunnel that goes under the road. But these projects are expensive. They require community support, and they're really only useful along roadways that turtles already commonly cross. Indirectly, the best way that you can help turtles is to think about how your actions to the land affects their lives. You can do things like clear the debris away from storm drains so that it doesn't wash into the drain and out into the waters where turtles live. You can promote the use of native plants in rain gardens or meadow lawns to increase habitat and improve ecosystem diversity. And of course, you should drive carefully and always remember that somewhere a turtle is on the move.